Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Let's begin with today's class. In today's class, we are going to study about the planning and the conservation of resources, which means that how can we conserve the natural resources. In our earlier chapter, I already explained you about the planning and conservation, that we should save the natural resources as we have a very, very limited natural resource, right? We don't have all the resources available in plenty, so we should use it very wisely and very carefully so that the future generation may also get the chance, or they also can live in this way or in this lifestyle, right? So it is very important to conserve, which means to save our resources and to find an alternative as well, right? So it is very important that our natural resources should be conserved, and if we don't have enough natural resources, we should start finding, or we should start developing new techniques to form an alternative, right? To form another way or another process of obtaining that minerals. Either we can also do or make some new techniques to use that renewable resources instead, right? So that we can make that renewable resources more and more, we should produce that minerals and resources more. So we are going to study here some points which are for the understanding of the conservation of resources in detail. So the first point over here is that what we should do is, first of all, we should gather the information about the availability of utilized, unutilized and probable resources in any region or country as a unit. So basically we should do a research about that particular resource. For example, petroleum, right? So petroleum includes all the fuels like petrol, kerosene, diesel, right? This all are petroleum, right? So to study more about to conserve that resource, what we should do is we should first of all gather the information that in how much quantity is that natural resource is available to us, how much quantity is not used, and how much is the probability of that resources that we can get, right? Of any region, wherever that mineral or that natural resources is getting from that area or from that country, we should first research on that, about its availability, about its utility, right? Along with that, the second point is that the resources which are limited or non-renewable should be exploited scientifically and should be used only where it is necessary to use them. I have told you many times in our earlier videos as well that we should use the resources in a very limited manner. We should use it only when it is necessary. We should not waste that resources, because the non-renewable resources are in a very limited quantity. So we should not waste that resources. Instead, we should use it very, very carefully, and we should save that resources as much as possible. We should only use it where it is extremely important, right? Other points we have is that attempts should be made to develop those resources the quantity of which can be increased. So along with that, we should also try that the resources which is getting scanty or which is getting low, we should try that we can make that resources more and more, we can produce that resources more, right? We should attempt that we can develop that resources in more quantity. Then the fourth point we have is that the resources which are cheaper are easily available should not be wasted. See, one more thing, we should not waste the non-renewable resources, but along with that, we should also not waste the renewable resources. It's not that because it is available and scanty, we should waste that. No, it is not that. If it is available in a very bulk quantity or in a very large quantity, or it is in a very cheaper, we can get it in a very cheap price, right? But we should not waste even that resources also. Instead, we should be used sparingly for the future use, right? So we should use that resources also very carefully, so that not only us but our future generation may also not suffer because of this resources. After that, we have the next point is that those resources which are in a limited quantity should be conserved, right? The resources which are in a very limited quantity, we should save that resources and we should also find alternative options, right? See, I told you this thing also that we should find the alternative options, right? For example, I'll give you one good example of it. Like till now we had seen many vehicles which almost all the vehicles used to run on fuel, right? Either it was a petrol or diesel, right? Anything, right? Either CNG, right? But along same thing, that petrol is again a non-renewable resources, which means that petrol, we cannot get petrol in a very like normal 10 to 20 years, right? It takes thousands of years to form. So that resources is again a non-renewable resources. So what we did is, with the help of technical development, we formed electrical vehicles and cars and two-wheelers, right? So this is what we need to do is, if we know that this particular resources is not going to be available to us in the future, then we should start finding the another options for that particular thing through the help of technical and scientific way, right? So this is what we need to do, is that if the resources are in a limited quantity, if we know that particular resources will not be found in the future, then we should start finding the alternative options with the help of technical development in favorable for the long-term process, right? After that, the next important point is that necessary laws should be formed for the conservation of resources and should be enforced strictly, right? So if along with that, we can also do one thing is that we can make certain laws for the conservation of resources, right? For example, trees. I told you this example in the last video also, that the earlier there was no punishment or no fines for the person who used to cut the trees, right? But because as we can see that our atmosphere is changing, the pollution was increasing, there was rainfall, very less rainfall, and because of less rainfall there was water scarcity, right? So to protect that thing, what the government did is government started making laws for the people who used to cut the trees, right? So same way we can do for the conservation of resources as well. We can make certain laws and rules, and that laws and rules should be followed strictly, right? So this way we can conserve our resources. Citizens should be well acquainted with all facts associated with the rational usage of resources, and a public awareness should be cultivated. So along with that, we should also make people aware about this thing, that the resources they are using are very less and they should protect it, and they should all be aware about how it is being cultivated, right? So this all thing should be, public awareness should be created in terms of how they can protect the resources, how they should use the resources and all, right? So this was how we can conserve or how we can protect our resources. Now we are going to see the next topic is about soil formation, right? Now whatever we are going to study in this chapter is related to soil. So the first topic over here is soil formation. Formation means how is the soil created. So the basically in this formation we are going to see how it is made and how it is, what it needs to be created, right? What soil needs. So generally the part of the surface of the earth wherein the vegetation grow is known as soil. So basically the surface of the earth, right, the land you can see on which we live, or the land which is the upper part of the earth or the surface of the earth where we grow vegetation. Vegetation, again, we understood in our first chapter that vegetation means not vegetables, but it means that forest and plants, crops, whatever things which are being grown on the surface of the land or on the surface of the earth is called vegetation, right? So vegetation is grown on the soil. The soil is a thin layer composed of various elements on the surface of the earth. So basically this layer or this part of the soil is the surface of the earth, and it has various elements. Soil has many different elements. Soil is not made up of one particular thing. It is made up of very different elements, right? Composed of many different elements. Minerals, humidity, humus and air are mixed up in it. So there are also many minerals, there are humidity, right? The humidity means the hotness, there is humidity in the soil, right? And humus means there is some natural things which are also mixed along with that, and there is air in the soil, right? So this all thing is mixed in the soil. The parental rocks lie below the soil. So below the surface of the soil there are these layers of parental rocks. So parental rocks are basically a helping hand to the soil. If parental rocks were not there, there was no soil, right? Soil is formed due to the materials available through the denudation. So basically denudation is the process of from which the soil is made. So for example, there is a huge stone, right? So that huge rock or that huge stone travels either through water, either through like rain, or either through air, right? And what happens while it travels, the layers of that rock or that particular stone gets cutted off, right? And slowly slowly the parts from which it forms dust, that's rock, the upper layers or the some parts, it breaks into pieces, and that pieces again forms into very minute small pebbles, right? So that all thing or that process is called denudation, which is basically a process of formation of soil. Biotic remnants, humidity and air gets mixed up with it. So biotic remnants means the leaves or the dead bodies of the animals and birds gets mixed with that mixture of the rocks and the dust, right? So that along with that, there is humidity. Humidity means the hotness which is there in the moist which is there in the soil is called the humidity, and there is air. So this all things together mixes up and it forms soil. In other words, the soil is a natural mixture of minerals and biotic animals which have the capacity to grow and develop vegetation. So basically the soil is a natural mixture. See, this all things are mixed naturally, right? Biotic remnants, humidity and air, this all things are natural mixture. That is why it is called as natural mixture. No human goes and mixes that soil up, right? So that is why it is called as natural mixture. And this natural mixtures of biotic animals, right, which is formed from the nature, is called and is that makes that mixture makes soil, and that mixture or that component has the capacity to grow and develop vegetation. And that mixture which is formed, that mixture has the capacity of growing vegetation, or either it is vegetation means all forms of plants and trees, right? Plants, crops, trees, everything comes in vegetation, right? So this soil has the capacity to develop and grow vegetation. So here I'm going to stop with our chapter. We'll continue the chapter in our next class, right? Till then, take care. Thank you.